So Waterloo Nuit is a story which has some fictional elements and non and historic elements. The historic elements are the children of the propaganda minister of the Third Reich, Joseph Goebbels. He had six children from the age from 1 to 8, and when the story starts, they are very little, and the eldest daughter, she is telling the story of her life, and she's talking about the war and what they experienced from their parents, and they live like in a bubble where they hear from the war, but their life is very safe. And they play war, but they live in a luxurious environment. It's a strange atmosphere. And then there is a second person in the book, which is a sound technician, and he collects voices, human voices. He's like a mad scientist, and he makes a big archive of human voices. And he meets this girl, Helga Goebbels, in the bunker of Adolf Hitler, because he was there too to record the last words of Adolf. Yes, but in the end, the girl and the old man, they get friends, and he records their voices, and it's a sad story. The main interesting thing is that how is it for children when your parents kill you or want to kill you because of ideological madness, because they thought that after Hitler's death there will be no future for their Nazi children. And that's why they killed them. They didn't even ask them. Yeah. And the frightening thing is that the children didn't know it. The parents told them always stuff like, there will be an airplane which saves us. Take these pills. It's a sleeping pill. You will awake then in a safety environment. And the eldest daughter, she is suspicious. She is 14 and she realizes that her parents are lying. And that must be a very tough situation for a 14-year-old girl if you start thinking that your mother wants to kill you and you cannot tell it to your siblings because they will be frightened. So it's a very strange situation for the girl. And I found it interesting to draw. There is a very big literature house, publishing house in Germany, which is called Zurkamp, very famous. They make great literature, like from Thomas Bernhard and Handke and really all the famous authors. And they asked me to make an adaptation of one of their novels, and I have total free choice. I could do everything I like. And I read a lot of these books, and this story with the Goebbels children I find so fascinating because it had such a dark and fantastic atmosphere, and I found the language very impressive of the novel. And I thought, does it make sense to make a visual adaptation of these words? And I found it very... I thought, yes, I can do something interesting, because to make an adaptation of a novel doesn't mean that you make a summary of the novel. It has to have... The novel is perfect for itself. You don't need the comic. But if there is something inside which you can really show in a comic, which is not in the text so much, you know, where I can add something new, then... Yeah, then it makes sense, and it was there. I thought this text is so fascinating, the words I like. I like the scenario. I'm interested in the main figure of Helga Goebbels. I'm interested in historic comics. I like to draw historic comics.